Well, I should begin with saying that quantum mechanics is one of the greatest discoveries of the previous century. It is a marvelous theory that puts everything in context about the atoms, the molecules, and the entire subatomic world. It is all quantum mechanical. But the strange thing about it is, in spite of the fact that it's so successful in describing the world that we know, it nevertheless doesn't describe anything that looks like reality. So we are used to working with this complex equations. So the equations were being discovered and they work extremely well. But then you ask, what do these equations mean? And the consensus that people in the previous century reached was that you simply shouldn't ask. You should just calculate and you'll get the right answers, so why worry? You get the answers that are observed in any experiment, so why worry? And the reason is, I think, that reality is very important if you want to have a theory that sounds more likely to be true than another theory. So if the choice is a theory that describes real things as if they are real, as they are, or real things as just mixtures of unreal, ghost-like objects, then that theory has a much smaller chance of being correct. So I want to know if the theories we have today actually describe reality or not, and if not, can we cure the disease? Can we make a better theory that does describe things as if they are real? I say as if because subatomic particles are so small and so many of them that you cannot really describe them the way they are. That's hopeless. But we can try to describe them the way they could be, and the way their description makes totally sense. Like you talk about stars and planets, you also talk about stars and planets that we never have seen, but we know that they are there. So the same thing about particles. We know that there are too many of them to keep them all apart and to say this one is real, this one is imaginary. That's not the way it goes. They're all real. But we want to have a credible model that describes their being real. And this is our difficulty today, that models of quantum mechanics today don't even allow us to do that. And now it becomes more serious. We're doing something wrong. Quantum theory is, on the one hand, so beautiful it shouldn't be corrected. But our interpretation of quantum mechanics should be corrected, because this interpretation is something that which I find not very desirable. It's hard to say why it has to be wrong, but it's just not credible to me. I think with Einstein, I like to ask the question, no, is the moon there if nobody looks? And the answer is, of course the moon is there if nobody looks, what you're talking about. And this is the way I would like people also to talk about elementary particles. Of course, these particles are there, and of course, this beam of particles that we create is a beam of real physical particles, and some of them move this way, some of them move that way. We don't know exactly where all particles go, every single one of them, but we know how they go on the average. Now, quantum mechanics only describes that average and never goes beyond that. But I think we should try to go beyond that and say that this is a realistic scenario of what could be happening and how we could be describing reality. I've been at a festival like this before in the Netherlands called Lowlands, where the setup was a little bit similar, but there are more rock stars performing, so on. So my performance looked like a performance of a rock star, which I'm not used to as a scientist at all. But otherwise, it was the same sort of spirit, that we're asking real questions and we give a talk, but the whole event was orchestrated much more precisely than usual in our field. I liked very much the discussion that we had afterwards. There was directly after my talk a short period of questions. Yeah, people ask relevant questions, so they could be answered. But after that, there was a special session, discussion session, in a more relaxed sphere with a smaller group of people, and we had some good talks. Yes, that went quite well.
For more debates, talks, and interviews, subscribe today to the Institute of Art and Ideas at IAI TV.